Thank you for joining today's session. It will be our 21st session for Integration Architecture Certification Preparation. And today's topic is Salesforce to Salesforce Integration. This is a standard feature in our Salesforce org. So before starting with the learning of this feature, let me introduce me. I am Dhanikla Sahani. I'm a Technical Architect in Context Business Solution. I'm a Certified Application Architect. Okay, and if you want to connect me, my Twitter handle is Dhanik Sahani. I also write blog related to the Lightning, okay, Lightning Web Component, okay, integration and architecture related things. So if you want to discuss me about these topics as well, please ping me on Twitter or LinkedIn. I will be actually very happy to help you. Today's topic, okay, is actually part of integration architecture concept, which is around 28% of our exam. So you can think it's a very important topic. And in today's actually session, we will see what is Salesforce to Salesforce integration, what are the ways we can actually integrate two Salesforce system, how to connect two Salesforce system using that feature, S2S feature. And after the connection, whatever record we are saving, how to create a report for all those actually records which we shared between two org, okay? What are the guidelines if you are going to use S2S feature of our Salesforce org? And parallelly, we will see the demo as well. So what is Salesforce to Salesforce integration feature? We already discussed about REST API, we already discussed about SOAP API and many actually other API, Python event, bulk API, all those things. And most of them actually help us to integrate a third-party system. So this feature actually is important or is useful when actually you have vendor or you have a partner who is already associated with you, okay? And when they are associated with you, actually they are business entity in your org. So if a person, if a entity, if a business who already a business record, a business entity in your system, and they also run, they also use Salesforce system. So if you want to share data between that system, their system or that org system, then we can utilize this Salesforce to Salesforce integration. Okay, in this case, actually there is no API call is required. We will go just with the standard feature and it's no code approach. There's no code required in this approach. So you can think this is how important, how useful this feature is. So when we integrate two orgs, we are actually sharing of data between each other, maybe because sharing of data between them, maybe the first org can actually share the second org can also share the data with the first org. Okay, so it's very important, and integration can be bi-directional as well. I already told, so both org can actually participate in sharing the data, so it's very easy to share the data, and that's why it's called a bi-directional as well. So apart from Salesforce to Salesforce integration, what are the other features we can utilize to connect to Salesforce system? So we already have REST API, we have a SOAP API, we have SSO, which is a single sign-on concept. And apart from this S2S tool, we have fourth one. And apart from all these four, which is mentioned here, we can utilize the ESB tool or the MuleSoft to integrate to Salesforce org system. So our topic is related to the standard feature, which is one orange highlighted S2S tool. Let's focus on this tool and see what is that. So when we want to connect, when we want to share data between two Salesforce org, okay, some steps is required. So what are those steps? So in first step, actually we have to enable Salesforce to Salesforce system feature. Again, this feature actually need to be enabled in both systems. If you are not enabled, actually, if any of the org doesn't have this feature enabled, then they will not able to share the data. So this feature need to be enabled in both org, okay? Second, create connection between orgs. So after that, the enablement of that S2S feature, you have to create a connection between two orgs. So it indicates, okay, now we and other partner org is now connected and they can share the data. Third, once the connection is established, the third step is which objects data you want to share, and in that object, how many fields data you want to share with the partner org. Okay, maybe in one of the object you have thousands of, this is not thousand, it's 200 or 300 fields. Okay, and you want to share those fields. So in that case, you need only three or four column you want to share, then we can actually mark, okay, only these three fields need to be shared with the business partner. So that we can configure in the third step. Fourth step, basically, once the we have published, basically, whatever fields, whatever object you want to share with that party, destination, or the, your business partner, you have to publish that field, and the subscriber or the you can, your partner has to accept that those fields, okay, or object, and that's called as subscribing to that particular object and fields. And after that, actually, because all those data which we shared, you want to see those, you want to visualize all those shared records. For that, you have to create a list view in your account object or whatever object you are sharing with our destination system or your partner. So in that object, we have to create a list view to identify what are the records actually shared between that partner org or somebody. The partner org also has shared with you. So all those details we can see by creating a list view. Now let's go each step one by one. Enabling S2S. So for enabling S2S, because before starting or using this concept, we have to enable S2S feature. And anybody cannot actually enable this feature. For enabling that feature, Salesforce to Salesforce integration, this feature is required. Modify all data. Permission set is required. So what you have to do, you can create a permission set, and from that permission set you can assign the permissions to the user who has power or who has access, or you want to give the access to create a connection. Maybe sometimes it normally is happen using the supervisor or business owner or system admin can do the activity. So you can assign these permission set to those kind of user. After enabling Salesforce to Salesforce, we cannot disable it. This is one of the you can drawback or limitation you can see. But even if you have enabled it, and if you want to, you are not able to disable it, there is no problem. Until you are not sharing, you are not publishing record, it will not share to the destination system or destination org. So it's okay even if you have enabled it. This is only available in classic mode. This is a third and you can say important limitation that right now you cannot use this S2S feature in lightning mode. You have to use classic mode to work on this feature. After that configuration, actually, whenever you enable it, actually email actually sent, because for now, because when you are connected with two, a lot of email exchange will be done. Okay, when you want to connect, you want to share the record. So email will also share with them, okay, you have shared 10 record, you have shared 50 record, or whatever fields you have updated for the particular record, all those communication will be done. So once we enable S2S thing, we have around 4 or 5 template need to be used, okay. So, and if you based on your company guideline, if you want to change those template, you can change the template so that whatever information you want to say go, that the information will only go to the destination or the business partner. We can also configure the email address, because from which email address that email will be sent, okay, and what email template will be required, all those configuration we can do. So let's see this step in our for that what we I have done. This is my okay, for right now, for this org, S2S feature is already enabled, okay. Let me show that. Salesforce to Salesforce setting. You can see this feature is already enabled. And I already told we have a 5 email template, like invitation, deactivation, accept an invitation. So whenever we connected, the email will be sent to the business partner that you have to accept my invitation. For that email template is created. If you want to change those template, you can go and change. So now, because we have enabled it, let's go to the next step. After that, we have to configure permission set, okay, with manage connection and manage queue. So after that, you have enable it S2S feature, okay. And if you want to basically use the next step, so first we have to create a permission set and assign these two permission to the that permission suite. Again, in this step also, whatever permission set you have created, share this permission suite or assign this permission suite to the respective user, maybe the admin or your business owner, okay. And after that, you have to create a connection with the account object. Now, because I already told that that particular destination or particular business partner is already part of your account object or account record. So you have to create a connection with that particular account. Okay. Account is, you can say, business account, which is holding the your business partner detail. Once we create a connection, an email will be sent to the target organization. Okay. And the target organization has to accept that invitation so that the connection will be established. Okay, once we enable S2S, we can get a connection tab. Without that acceptance or the creating that thing, we cannot get the connection tab. Connection tab can also be used to public and subscribe. So connection tab is, you can say, dashboard for the all those thing for the S2S feature. You can publish, you can reject, you can deny, all those things you can do in your connection tab itself. So let's see how to connect or how to create a connection between Salesforce Org. So I already created, okay, let's create a connection now. Let me show which account object I have. I have created this XYZ IT system. For that, I have one contact as well, Meep Sahni. Okay, and I want to create a connection between this XYZ IT system. So for that, let me go there and go in the connection tab, create a new connection. And now I have to select the account. So for selecting account, you can use XYZ IT system, and the contact will be the Meep Sahni, which already told. And now send a invitation. So once I will save it, an invitation will be sent to the Meep Sahni, basically because that email ID we have got for this particular account. Or maybe whoever with the actual owner, actual contact person for that account, the email will be sent to that person. So right now for that entity, we have a Meep Sahni. Now you can see that email is already sent to that email ID. So let's see that we have received that email or not. Now you can see the Condon Business ID, okay, Condon Business Solution has invited you to connect in the Salesforce Org. Okay, so dear me, this all those detail and the link. So basically we have to accept the link or to get the connection done. So let's link that. I have to use my credential. So what I have done, the Nick.Sahani Sahani. Let me log in it. Now, you don't have the level of access necessary to perform the operation you requested. We are getting this error. So this error is why? Because we have not enabled Salesforce to Salesforce feature in the target org. So let me do that first. So we are right now in our Lightning experience. Let's see if we are getting Salesforce to Salesforce feature here or not. You can see this feature is not in the Lightning mode. Let me move to the Salesforce Classic and setup. And then you can see that now I am getting that setup menu. Let's go into setting. Right now this is disabled. Let me enable it. So I am enabling the Salesforce to Salesforce setting. Now we get again the setting is enabled. Let me open that link once again. Let me log in here. Now you can see, okay, earlier we were getting some different kind of error. Now we are getting that acceptance page. So let me accept. It's saying, okay, the Condom Business Solution has invited your company to connect. So do you want to accept or not? So let me accept this. So now the connection is between the Condom Business Solution and XYZ IT system is established. After that, we have to publish objects and fields which need to be shared with the business partners, between the business partner. For that, what we have to share records with another Salesforce organization, we must first publish the object that we want to share. And once we publish an object, we can also select which individual fields on that object are published, okay, or need to be shared. So let's go in my source org, okay, and then let me publish that particular. So what I want to do, I want to publish case object, okay? I want to share the record or the cases which is created in my org to them, their system. So I am selecting case, and case is created. After the case is created or published, I have to use or I have to select out of the whatever the fields I want to send with them. Let me use account ID, case number, case origin, case type. Okay. And then we have phone number and the email address. These details I want to share with the target organizations or the partners org. So now this part is done. The next part is we have to subscribe to objects and fields which is shared by our business partner. Subscribe to objects and field that your business partner has published. Okay, we have to subscribe those fields and on object. Subscribe to an object and map it to an object in your organization. Basically, for what object, in which object you want to share. Let's example, there is one custom object in their system, maybe vendor. And you want to put that data in vendor detail. So that kind of mapping we can also establish in our destination org. Okay, so that kind of mapping of changing the org, object name we can do. But for the standard object, we cannot change. That will move to the specific that object only. Like account will only go to the account, case will go to the case only. But in case of custom object, you can change the mapping table name. Standard object must map to the standard object, but we can map custom object to any custom object, which I already told you. When your business partner update the fields on the record that you are sharing, the fields will be updated on the shared record in your organization. So basically, whenever we are sharing a record, and whatever record we have shared, and it is already accepted by the destination org. So whatever change we will do in that org, it will automatically reflect in the connected org. That is actually benefit, okay? So let's see how we can subscribe in destination org. So this is our destination org or the business partner org. So we have already established the connection. Let's now the next step is we have to subscribe that whatever published object are there. So let's go in a subscribe menu. And which you can see the case we are getting. Already told whatever they have shared, we can go and come there. So now we have to basically map, okay, this case will be mapped to the case, okay? After that, auto accept whatever record they are sharing. Let's accept all those record and you save it. So now you have subscribed that field, okay? Subscribe that object. Now whatever subscribed you have object you have done, now you can map the fields which is actually published. So you can see all those fields which we have published in from the source org. Now we are in target of all those list comes. So we can change those details. Like account ID normally come as a name, case number is a case num, case origin, case region I'm mapping, case type is I'm mapping case type, email address to email address, and phone to phone. Mapping I have done. Okay. And save it. So now we have saved it. So this field is more than once to their field. Okay, case number, sorry. Let me do account ID. So we have mapped the detail, map the object and the field as well in the destination orb as well. So next object, next thing is let's save some record from the source orb to the destination orb. Let me go there. Let me create a new case, not the existing. Let me create a new case here. I am using the contact, which is of Mr. Mirsani. Okay, say all is selected and product detail, transfer, and type is equal to mechanical, case region is equal to equipment complexity. Let's save it. Now you can see when you have all open cases, now this record case I have created just now, and I want to save this record to the destination orb. So we have to select, so it's not only single, you can select multiple record as well. So let's select, I want to select only this record, and after that you have to use forward to connection. That's you want to forward this record to the connected orb. So click on forward to connection. And you can see whatever connected org you have, all those lists will come here. So right now we have only one connected org, so we are getting this name only. So select that one and send notification. Once it will send, it will also send an email to your destination org contact person and forward existing related record. So whatever existing related records we have for this cases, it will also move there. So save it. And just wait for the some time in the destination org. Let me show the cases here. Good. Right now we have only three records. Just wait for some time and the we will get the email as well. Okay, that okay, we have received one email. Now we can say notification of new cases from the content management solution. So one new case have been assigned to your company. And then you can see that list right now. You can see the only three record. Let me refresh it, and now you can get this fourth record as well, which is created in the source org. Okay. Now let me update some of the detail in the source org. Let me change going with this record and detail. Let me edit instead of case region. Equipment complexity, let me change to the performance and type mechanical to the electrical. Save it and just wait for some time again in this case also, and the update will come here and details. Right now you can see there is mechanical and equipment complexity as a case season. It need to be changed to the type is equal to electrical, and the case region will come as a performance. Let me just give a seconds, or basically it might be in some situation it could be a 1 minute as well. Okay, but it will save as soon as that will come. Taking some time, and all those you can, the highlight section, you can also see that this is showing that okay, this is externally shared, this record actually externally shared. Again, and last modified, basically you can see the connected user, this record actually we have received from the connected user, that is indicating it. So for normal user or local record which you have created in this org only, you will get the respective user who is created. So that will be done. For in the case of the record, which is now you can see the type is now changed to electrical, and the case region is again changed to the performance. So whatever update, once the record is shared between two org, and if you are updating some detail, it will change, okay, the that search for connected orgs data again as well. There is no notification or no movement or no basically code forward to connection setting is required. Everything will be done automatically. Okay. Next, Add sharing record list in the pager. So as already mentioned, now we have connected. After the connection, you are sharing the record. Now you want to know how many records we have, okay, shared between two orgs. So how to identify that? So for that, what you can do, you can create an external related list to the page layout. So for what you can do, so in this page layout itself, right now there's nothing. Let me add one related list, which is for the external sharing. I'm adding on top, save it. So once after that, you can see that you are getting that detail, the detail of the organization from where you have get this, you have received this record. So it's saying that is this record is received from the content business solution, and that is taken care of by the external sharing object or related list. After that, now I already told that, okay, we have got that cases. Now, how to identify, if you have a list view, how to identify that this record is received from the connected org? So for that, what you can do, you can change your list view, okay? And from here, you can actually add these two columns, received connection name and sent connection name. So received connection name, basically, when you are receiving a record, then it will come. And when you are sharing a record, then it will go to the sent connection name. Okay. Okay. So basically saying this record we have received from the content business solution company. Okay. Which is your partner. Create custom list view on the external sharing related list when give access to the paper tutor. As also mentioned, we have added two columns for that from the external sharing related list. And add the received connection name, the sent connection name, column for the relation of page layout, which already mentioned. Okay. So based on that, we can easily get the record. Okay. Or what you can do, you can also create a new list view to just to for your purpose. Let's example, I want to go over connected records. I want to create a new list view for that purpose only. So in that case, what you will do, you can change the last connection, last modified by alias is equal to connected user, connection user. Okay, and say we will see that records are saying no one is there. Looks like the name is different for this one. This one is connection user. Let's go in that connected records, edit. Last modified date alias equals to all courses, but it's not sharing, showing data. Let me use other feature. Let's show that different approach. If not sharing, I delete should go and show that record. Last receive connection name not equal to blank. Now we have received that. Okay, so based on that, you can create a list view and you can assign that particular list view to the user who actually work on this connected records thing. Okay. Next, we have share record using S2S. So forward records to the another server. So what is the way to actually you can exchange the records? So basically, what you have to share record with that connected organization using Salesforce to Salesforce feature. You have to select that particular record, which I already mentioned, and number of record you can also select, and then you have to select forward to connection button, and that it will share with the all those connected org which you have selected in the next step. Okay, let me show how, where is that thing. So let's here in this org connection tab. cases, sorry, not connection, cases, because you are sharing records of the cases, then it basically showing. So basically whatever record you want to share, once you select it and click on the forward to connection to share the record. This is a way actually do. The second way we have, if you have added, let's take example, I want to add, okay, external sharing this page layout or related list in this org as well. From there also, actually, you can share the record. Because this record is already shared, it's showing here. Otherwise, you can, let's go and use another case. Okay, let me use this case. This case is actually not actually forwarded to that one. So you can see, you are getting forward this case. So this button will come on the object which you are connected. So there will also, this is the second way. First way is you can go to the list view and select all those records and share with the forward to connection. The second way, if you are going to specific record, go to that record, add the external sharing as a related list. And from external sharing related list, you will get that button. Forward this object name will come and you click with that one. It will ask with which connection you want to share this record. Select that and you just save it. So based on that, it will share the record to that destination org. Then automatically accepting related records from the connection org. So once the connection is established and you have already shared the record to the destination org, so after that, whatever changes we are doing will automatically go. And the whatever record we are sharing, if they have a related record as well, let's say account and contact, so those are related when you are sharing contact, because the related record is account, so it will automatically move to the destination org. So this setting, what you do, you can see forward existing related record as well. So the checkbox you have to select and it will go to the it will, all the child record will also go or with the destination org. Now, because we have established, we have shared record, we have seen that record in our list view. Now, as a supervisor, as a business owner, I want to know what are the activities we are performing with the Salesforce, what are the record we have shared, whatever the record which we have received from that. I want to know as a report. I want to know as a daily report. I want to know as a weekly report. For creating a report, what we have to do? We cannot do that. So for that, we have to create a custom report type with the that activity, okay, that connection history activity, and then only we can utilize that that custom report to create all those, get all those connection records. So let's see that how we can do that. Okay, first we have to go in the this org. Probably, I think I already created a connection report, custom report. We have custom report type. Let me see that we already have or not. Connection with accounts. So let's create with those connection with cases. Get cases. Now, where you want to store it? So you want to store a customer support report, and this is the, I've given the description. Now go and save this custom report. Now primary object in our case, secondary object, what will be the secondary object for this report type? So for the connection, we have a connection history object for all the transaction. All those detail will be there in the connection history. So let's see that connection histories. We have to use this object for getting all those detail. Save it. Now our connect report type is created. After that, what we have to? We have to go and create a report based on that connection. So based on this custom report type, so where I have saved? I have shared in the customer, my personal customer report account. Connected cases. Second. Let me go and see where I have created that report. Report type, new. We have connected cases and we have shared in customer support reports. Okay, so let me see, we have customer report support. Oh, this is not there actually, and that's why it's not showing. But let me change that one. Okay, let's change the report type category to someone accounts and contact, or not contact. Okay, that's right. Now we are only going with this only category. We can create customize, we can create our custom cut as well. So now that record is there in the contact and okay, sorry, let's go and create a new report. From here actually we'll go in the connected cases and then create it. Now you can see we have, based on that created custom report, we can actually create a, we have created the report, and here actually I want to show that connection name from where the record is shared. It's not showing any detail because we have used my cases. Let me create all cases and date and time also close. So clear this range all time. Now you can see that I am getting a record which is shared. Okay, let me share my personal room itself, save and run report. So now you can see this case actually is shared with the XYZ IT system. So based on that, we can create a scheduler report as well. We can create a weekly or monthly report, and we can publish with our supervisor, manager, or the org's manager, basically, or entity owner. So this is the way we can create a report to share all the activity which is performed with the connected org. Now we have performed all those things. What are the guidelines if for the S2S? System administrator actually can share all those records, and but most users can only forward records that they own actually. So this is actually, let me see that. Okay, system administrator can share all records, but most users can only forward records that they own. Okay, you can stop sharing a related record from its parent record. So how to do that? Okay, for doing that, you have to go in the related record which is shared, and you can see stop sharing button. Okay, from there you can actually stop that. To stop sharing a record, view the record and click stop sharing in the external sharing display. So already show, okay, we view the record, and from there actually you can stop the sharing of that particular record. After that you have shared, so stop sharing. Okay, whatever actually that establishment is done, that is closed or deactivated. So once that, once they will change the record, once they update the record, you will not get any notification for that. And you can only stop sharing records that you or your subordinate owns. You cannot actually stop sharing for others' record. If any other records been accepting a record, okay, see the connection history for the detail. This connection history tab, basically you will get, basically it's saying like this is the actually connection history there. Whatever things we are doing, all actually being tracked, always being logged in this connection history tab. So you can go and check all those activities here. And a maximum of 100 tasks per related record can be shared. Okay, maximum 100 tasks we can share. And after accepting a shared record, if you update a field that your business partner has subscribed to, the field is automatically updated on the record in your business partner organization, which I already saw that I updated one of the field. Okay, type, and it is reflected in the destination or the business partner or. So I've already shown the demo, all those demo which is required for each step, and I'm done with the session. If you have any question, okay, please speak, or otherwise you're gonna ask, or otherwise we can close the session. Thank you.